Hello, this is Alex with Headway Apps. Today I'm gonna talk about our Google Docs add-on, FileDrop. I'm gonna show you a few things that it can do. If you work with Google Sheets and you insert PDFs or images in your Google Sheets, it's really gonna help your productivity because it really has some amazing features, especially built for that. It's a sort of file manager that helps you increase productivity when you work with files in the Google Workspace space tools. So it works with Google Sheets, it works with Google Docs, and also with Google Slides. So let's get started. This is the interface that you're gonna see when you start the add-on. You can find it in the Google Workspace, Workspace Marketplace actually. You just search for FileDrop and it's gonna show up. Now, what we're gonna do, we're gonna insert some files and see what other things FileDrop can do. Let's get started. This is the upload interface. You can drag and drop files here, or you just click on it and you can just insert files. I'm going to insert this invoice here. What it does is uploading the file in your Google Drive and it's going to link it here. Let me do that again because I have it as an image in cell and I want to show you that later. So let's do that again. Let's choose another file. As you can see here now, the file is inserted and it links to your file in Google Drive. And now we can work with images as well. We can, in the settings page, we have several options here. The one that we just used now, add it as a link. We can add image over cells, or we can add an image in a cell, and we can set the size of the cell where we're gonna insert the image. And yes, you can insert multiple images at once. Maybe you can do that now. Let's see what images we have here. Now the image uploads and it's in the file. Again, it has a link to it and you can copy it, open it. If you go over the image here in the upload area, you can insert it again. You can copy the link and you can paste it anywhere else where you need this to link this file, or you can delete it if you want. And it takes a bit, but it's gonna be deleted. The next thing we can do is extract text from the images or PDFs files we're uploading. For examples, this is an invoice and I need some information from the invoice. I can just click this icon here. And the information is extracted and I can paste it into my cells. If it detects tables, it's gonna you're going to be able to extract the information in tables. You can copy the information and paste it anywhere else where you need it. And also we can translate the information. So I'm going to insert it here as just regular info. So this is in Romanian, my native language. And if I want to translate this to, it will automatically detect the language, and I want to translate this to English. And now everything is in English here, and I can insert the information. As you can see, factura means invoice, total, total, supplier, it means furnizor, and so on. And you can do that with any PDF file or even an image. Another way I used it is, for example, if I want to take a screenshot of this and do this. I'm gonna save it. I'm gonna go back here. I'm gonna close this. So this. Paste it here. And I can extract the information I have in that image. Select the cell where I want my information to be pasted, and I insert it automatically. And pretty neat, I think, is this feature. What else can it do? Well, a few other things. It keeps a history of your files, the last 100 files that you have uploaded. So you don't need to upload this again. You can enter the images directly from here. And of course we have this icon where we extract the, so the OCR function. We can preview the files we've uploaded from here, and we can sort them by name, newer, older, or last viewed. We can even search the files in the history, and then we have the drive tab where we can go to any folder in our drive or shared drives if we have access to that. So we can view and insert files that are already in our Google Drive. We can preview them like this, again as list, sort them the same thing as we have in the library, and we can even search in Drive for the file that we need. We insert the file and it's just right here. Again, another few things that we can do is if we share these files with team members, for example, we can change the file upload access and give our team access to the files as well. By default, this is private, only us can see the files. So if now we're sharing this file with someone else, they won't be able to see what we've uploaded. But for example, if they are in the same domain as us, so we have a Google Workspace domain like at ourdomain.com, we select this and they already have the link, they will be able to see the files. Anyone in the domain, anyone with the link, again, or anyone if we're using a Gmail address, anyone with the link, or anyone is gonna work better. This setting must be done before we start uploading the files. Otherwise, we'll have to open each file and give them permissions to see it. A couple of things: we can export the sheet as PDF or export only the selected area. So if we want to export just this part of the sheet, we can do that. So that's it, that's about it for FileDrop. I hope you enjoy it and you're gonna use it. So if you're using any type of files with your Google Sheets, this is gonna increase your productivity 10 times. You can even upload from URLs, so that's another neat feature that you can use. Thank you. Cheers. Bye.